Oh, for the love of fucking God, where the hell is everything? Full of both me and Art. That doesn't sound right. I love hearing an orchestra. I guess that's what happens when I was basically raised to raised around music. Also, I just kind of want to see the cinematic. I just want to see that. Yeah, I'm not. Oh, wow. I just felt my spine pop in a couple places just breathing in. That felt amazing. Alright, I think I got some more dossiers. Is sound good to you, Billy? Because every time I've heard it and everything, everyone says that I'm too low, when in fact I'm actually a lot louder than everything else. Holy codex. Yeah. And journals. I fucking love the soundtracks, and what I love even more is when people make metal covers of them. Like, I love listening to Little V Mills on YouTube. I like how he does, like, metal versions of video games and, like, anime themes and things. And then there's... what's his name? Frog Leap Studios, who just basically just metalifies all of their music that's not metal, and it sounds fucking awesome. And he's also, and that guy's from Norway. Okay. I like to listen to a little bit of everything, but I can't English, just like Art. I can't fucking English, and English is his second language, I believe. Kinda. I love metal and rock, but I do like to listen to almost a little bit of everything else, except country music. Alright, I'm gonna make my rounds and talk to people.
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Not now. Working on collector data. Have ruled out artificially intelligent virus. Unless it's very intelligent. And toying with me. Tests. Anything else?
No.
I'll let you work.
We'll be here if you need me.
Although I do like how I changed Shepard's eyes to basically my eye color, because I've always had her with green eyes, and it's just kind of eh.
I saw the reports on Horizon, Commander. What you did was amazing. The report mentioned that Caden Alenko was there. How did that go?
It did not go well at all, and I do not miss that fucker.
There's not much to say. The past is the past.
I understand. Anyway, How may I help you, Commander?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Operative Lawson would like to see you at her station on the crew deck. Operative Taylor would like to see you over in the armory. Anything else, Commander?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
Okay, there's actually really nothing else to chat with her about yet.
Maybe we'll talk later.
Hey, Magnificent Gaming, how you doing?
Commander, you've received a...
Incoming message from Admiral Stephen Hackett, Alliance HQ.
Yes, the one mission that I suck at.
I need to discuss a sensitive matter with you privately.
I'll take this in my quarters.
I actually do enjoy... Okay. When it came to that first teaser trailer for Mass Effect Andromeda, and they use a Johnny Cash song, there were, like, people that were more of, like, a hardcore fan of Mass Effect that were in a fucking uproar about that. And I was like, I didn't understand why, because if you listen to the lyrics, and if you played the trilogy, or at least know of the story of the trilogy, it makes sense.
Name's Dr. Amanda Kenson. Dr. Kenson recently reported that she found evidence of an imminent Reaper invasion.
What's up, Digital?
So why call me?
Just this morning I received...
Well, there's going to be plenty of fails when I accept this mission.
They're holding her in a secret prison outpost on terrorism charges.
I am not stealthy whatsoever. I would suck at Hitman.
As a favor to me, I'm asking...
I have Hitman, too. I just haven't played any of them.
What's Dr. Kenson actually doing out there?
She's a deep cover operative, Shepard. We talk only when we have to. I'd heard she was investigating a rumor of a Reaper artifact in the system. Her last report said she'd found it.
What else can you tell me about the operative?
Amanda's a top scientist and an Alliance agent working in Batarian space. It's a deadly assignment, and she's one of the few up to the challenge.
You mean, Anna made it?
Pretty far, Commander. I won't let her rot away in a Batarian torture camp.
I thought the Alliance denies the Reaper threat. That must be some proof she found.
Kenson's team found an artifact out in Batarian space. She believes it's a Reaper device, proof that the Reapers are indeed planning to invade. I've known her a long time. If she says she has proof, it's worth checking out.
No, Admiral Hackett has balls to grow a mustache, even though he's got a scar on his lip where he technically can't really grow any facial hair there.
I have a hell of a squad with me. I'm sure they'd help out.
Kenson is my friend. If the Batarians see a squad of armed soldiers, they'll kill her. This is serious, Commander. Go in with discretion, or don't go at all.
The Batarians won't take kindly to the Alliance breaking into a secret prison.
This is not an Alliance operation. It's one person going in alone to save a friend. If it were an official mission, of course the Batarians would be upset. You keep this quiet, Shepard, and there's nothing to worry about.
I'll make this a priority.
The prison is hidden underground at a Batarian outpost in Arata.
Okay, should I collect more of my team, or should I go on this solo mission?
Once she's secure, confirm her...
I'm kind of thinking that I need to level up a little bit.
Got it.
Hackett out.
I think I want to level up a little bit more. I want to build my team. I'm not buying any fish yet. Why do I have no music in here? So, goddammit, this music is a priority. Thank you. I don't really need that yet. Yeah, that's good for now. Until I get some of my regular shit. No, I'm probably gonna get like a maybe two more. Oh, I might as well go talk to Miranda and Jacob. Well, Miranda's on this level, so I'll talk to her first.
Shepard, I find myself in the unpleasant position of asking for your help. I don't like discussing personal matters, but this is important.
Miranda, you're one of my crew. Tell me what's on your mind.
My father was extremely wealthy. He wanted the ideal daughter, and he paid a great deal to genetically tailor me. When I learned that my father was more interested in controlling a dynasty than raising a daughter, I left.
How'd your father take that?
He was less than pleased. Several of his security guards were injured in the process. He knows not to come after me. But this isn't about me. I have a sister, a twin, and he's still hunting her. Cerberus has kept her safe, until now. She's living a normal life on Ilium, safe and hidden from my father.
So you think your father's tracked her down?
Precisely, Commander. My sources indicate he knows that she's on Ilium. I've tried to keep her hidden without impacting her life, but I'm out of options. He's too close. I need to relocate my sister's family before it's too late.
Oh, there's the perfect butt shot. Where the fuck is Retro Knight? He's messing that ass.
What do you know about your sister?
She's my genetic twin. We're identical.
No, her butt actually looks better from the side view than the back view. But she deserves a normal life,
and she's going to get it no matter what.
Did your sister's family know about this? Are they okay with being relocated?
They know nothing. They're completely uninvolved. Normal. I told Cerberus, and they're coming up with a positive reason to move the family.
What do you need me to do?
My father is extremely persistent. I'd like to go to Ilium when Cerberus is moving the family to make sure none of his agents get too close. My contact's name is Lantea. She'll be waiting for us in the lounge near the Nos Astra docking bay.
Okie dokie, now to Jacob as I run around in circles. What the fuck, Shepard? Why the hell are you looking down at the ground? It's not like you have any pets on board.
Jacob wants to speak with you.
I know, I'm on my way over there, goddammit.
Commander, sorry I'm a little unfocused. Personal matter. It won't affect my duties.
The yeoman said you wanted to see me. What's this about, Jacob?
As I said, it's a personal matter. I don't want to waste our time if it turns out to be a goose chase, but... Well, I got pinged by a ghost the other night. Family.
I'm listening.
My private log got an update about the Hugo Gernsback, the ship my father served on. It sent an SOS last week, reporting a crash and requesting a rescue. Shepard, that ship went missing 10 years ago. I hadn't talked to my father for 3 years before that. I've buried everything but a body. I'm not convinced it isn't just some automated distress signal ticking over. It's been too long.
I'd think you'd be more excited that your father might be alive.
He wasn't around enough for me to have bad memories. It's an old, well-healed wound. But if he's actually alive and needs help... I also want to note that it's not normal procedure for distress calls to be routed to the Normandy.
What's up, Magnificent
Gaming? This was passed
to
my personal log through Cerberus filters.
Any signs that this is a Cerberus front? Who passed this to you?
I doubt the elusive man would let a direct operation stake hold this long. If there's a link, it's probably just about money. Cerberus needs diverse holdings to fund projects like, well, you. And whoever sent this my way covered their tracks. Someone could be fishing for favors, or thought it would get under my skin. Who knows with that bunch?
You didn't get along with your father?
He made no apologies, I'll give him that. You make a mistake, you own up to it. Even if you keep making it. Whatever problems we had were a lifetime ago. I've had 10 years to get to where I am. And as far as I know, he's still a ghost.
Tell me about the Hugo Gernsback and what it was doing.
privately held frigate. I looked over the mission brief when it disappeared. Nothing stood out. Typical research and grab operation. Find an uncharted planet, stake a claim, and establish as large a presence as you can as fast as possible to shut out competitors.
To be quite honest, I really wish they wrote Jacob a lot better.
I think we can spare the time. Pass the coordinates to Joker.
I appreciate that, Commander. I don't expect more than dusty old bones, but it'll be good to
You mean the
record.
Music in the captain's cabin? Or the, like, my sleeping quarters? The name of that song, I believe, is just, it's like Omega. Or Afterlife. It's something involving either Omega or it's called Afterlife.
No messages for you, Commander.
Yay! Can I go do shit now? Oh wait, I did not read that. Shadow Broker Intel. Oh, I guess this. Oh, that means I'll be ready for the Shadow Broker. Probably the fucking best DLC in this fucking game. Oh, go. We're leaving Horizon. Fuck that planet. Fuck Kaden, not literally. Jesus Christ. Am I looking at the right planet? I have no idea. Everything's covering everything. Wait, buy probes. Yeah, fuck it, I'll top it off. I don't give a shit. Welcome to Ilium. Okay, I'm not gonna be giving Liara the intel until later. To be quite honest, Liara is not one of my favorite characters, and I know she's BioWare's baby. Just kind of like how Garrus is their baby, too. Okay, so I want to go after Thane. Eh, screw it.
Welcome to Nos Astra, Commander Shepard. We've been instructed to waive all docking and administration fees for your visit. My name is Karina. If you need information about the area, it would be my pleasure to assist you.
Who instructed you to waive the fees?
The order came from Liara Tassoni, who paid all fees on your behalf. She also asked that I direct you to speak with her at your convenience. She's near the trading floor.
What can you tell me about Nos Astra?
It's an exciting city. We see a lot of new cultures and goods because of our proximity to the Terminus systems. At the same time, Ilium is still an Asari world. You should be as safe here as you would be on the Citadel. For your own safety, however, I recommend against signing anything.
What's so dangerous about signing something?
Ilium is a free trade world, Commander. Contract term requirements are more relaxed here than on other planets. It's a small price to pay for keeping our competitive edge in goods from the Terminus systems.
You mentioned trading. What gets traded on Ilium?
Anything you can imagine, Commander. Ilium is a wonderful world for those who can afford it. In order to remain competitive as a Terminus systems port, we've relaxed many of the standards you'd find on other Asari worlds. Most drugs are legal, provided they are labeled properly. You can buy almost any weapon or technology.
You can even buy indentured servants.
I can't believe an Asari world would allow slavery.
We try to avoid calling it slavery. All indentured servants on Ilium have voluntarily agreed to a term of service. Most choose indentured service as a means to pay off debt or avoid imprisonment. A contract holder is responsible for the well-being of her servants, and a servant's duties are agreed upon before the contract is signed.
You said Liara was here? What is she doing?
Liara is one of Nos Astra's most respected information brokers. Nos Astra is based upon trade. Information is valuable currency, and Liara has done quite well. As I said, you'll find her near the trading floor. She was looking forward to seeing you.
Do you have any recommendations about what to do on Nos Astra?
Our trading center is directly ahead. You'll find restaurants and shops nearby as well. I suggest you browse our shopping kiosks. You can find things on Nos Astra that you can't find anywhere else in the galaxy.
I don't think I'll be doing that.
I'm on a mission. Can you help me find someone?
I can help you find major entertainment centers or stores, but I'm afraid I can't point you to individual people. Liara is excellent at that type of work, however. I imagine she can help you.
Thank you.
Again, welcome to our city, Commander. Please enjoy your stay.
Customs records indicated just a car named
It
Samara
is amazing
is
on how different the Asari's look from the first three previous games to Andromeda.
Regarding the whereabouts of Thane Krios, the assassin on your dossier, as well.
We were always told that Ilium is one of the safest places in the galaxy, until you fell off the grid. Sign the wrong contract, join up with the wrong company, or walk down the wrong alley, and it's as dangerous as anywhere else. Don't let this place fool you. It's no safer here than Omega.
Towers, traffic, lights, and Asari everywhere you look. I thought about living here for a while, but everybody's so tight-ass. It's all about money to these people. I do what I do for the love of it. These people...
25.
2 years since the destruction of the Destiny Ascension, planning for the fleet of the new Allied Citadel Defense Unit have reached another impasse. The Asari Republic...
If I had my save file and everything, I would be talking to an Asari that's sitting right here and help her out with something, but oh well.
Welcome. You look like someone who needs high-quality equipment. Feel free to look around. My store has the best tech and biotic equipment on Ilium.
Is everything here so expensive? I'd planned to drop a lot of credits today.
Really?
I'm outfitting a team for a dangerous mission. I need the best, and I'm willing to pay for it, as long as you work with me.
Well, perhaps I could give you a preferred rate at the kiosk. Here, a small discount, and when I get special items in, you can take a look.
What kind of special items are we talking about?
Oh, you know, schematics, designs. Nothing illegal, but I may not have all the licenses to sell them.
I'll have a look around. This might be useful.
That shit's still expensive. Hey, what's up, Dark Shadow? Alright, I might as well fucking talk to Liara. But I'm not gonna give her the intel yet. Damn, Dark Shadow, you came just in time to see your waifu.
Hello, Commander Shepard. Liara will be pleased to see you.
You're Liara's assistant?
Yes. Liara relies upon me to acquire useful intelligence. I don't have her network of contacts, but I supply her with supplemental data. It's really an honor to work with her.
What's Liara's reputation here on Ilium?
She is greatly respected. In a few short years, she's amassed a sizable network of connections. She could have even more political power than she already wields if she weren't so focused on her personal goals. But I believe she should tell you about that, not me.
I'll talk to you later.
Of course, Commander.
Have you faced an Asari commando unit before? Few humans have. I'll make it simple. Either you pay me, or I flay you alive. With my mind. Shepard! Nixeris, hold my calls. Shepard. My sources said you were alive, but I never believed. It's very good to see you.
You have sources now?
A few. Sources, contacts, even a little hired muscle. I've been working as an information broker. It's paid the bills since you... Well, for the past 2 years. And now you're back, gunning for the collectors with Cerberus.
If you know that, then you know that I could use your help.
I can't, Shepard. I'm sorry. I have commitments here, things I need to take care of.
What kind of things do you need to take care of? Are you in trouble?
No, no trouble. But it's been a long 2 years. I had things to do while you were gone. I have debts to repay. Listen, if you want to help, I need someone with hacking expertise, someone I can trust. If you could disable security at key points around Ilium, you could get me information I need. That would help me a great deal.
If it'll help you, I'll take care of it.
When you hack one, a server will open somewhere nearby for a short time. You can download data from there, if you hurry. Thank you, Shepard. This may help me pay a great debt.
There's an Asari named Samara here on Ilium. Do you know where I could find her?
Samara? Yes. She arrived recently and registered with Tracking Officer Dara. You can find Dara at the transportation hub.
Why would Samara have to register with a tracking officer? Is she a criminal?
No. In fact, she's quite the opposite. Samara is a Justicar, one of an ancient sect of Asari warriors. Dara can tell you more.
I'm looking for Thane Krios. He's supposed to be here on Ilium.
The assassin? Yes. He arrived here a few days ago.
Dark Shadow, you can have your blue alien sex. I'm gonna have
Nisana
my green.
Dantius. He contacted a woman named Serena. Serena has an office in the cargo transfer levels. Perhaps she can tell you where Krios is.
That was all just off the top of your head?
I'm a very good information broker, Shepard. The world of intrigue isn't that different
from
a dig site.
And I know they're penciled on.
Except that the dead bodies still smell.
Thanks for the help. That's all I needed to know.
Of course. If there's anything else I can help you with, let me know.
Dark Shadow. As you can see right here, if you see this when you're talking to her, that starts your Shadow Broker DLC, okay? Just so you know. I won't be doing that here now because I'm not going
to
spoil it for you. I'm on a mission to go get my my drill. Hey, I like green. Green is my favorite color. And Thane just happens to be fucking sexy. Shut up.
Do you have anything flashier? I want something that says, I only.
A source reports that the attack on the human colony of Freedom's Progress is being investigated as a possible terrorist attack by dissidents from former.
We'll figure something out. Stop worrying. It's okay. I'll think of something.
You said synthetic insights would buy me. You said it was an easy sale.
I assumed they would want an AI tech. Hello, can I help you with something?
I need you to let that slave go. Now.
We prefer the term indentured servant. And I know that Batarian slavers have made humans understandably prejudiced against slavery. Before you do anything hasty,
dude,
know
it was
that
even
this quarry
before Batarians, and we're still going through that shit now.
The servitude contract is completely legal on Ilium. If you actually want to help the quarry and convince the synthetic insights representative to purchase her contract.
What if I bought her myself? I could let her go and everyone would be happy.
A gallant offer with three problems. First, her technical skill merits a contract of several hundred thousand credits.
There's also a fee for freeing me before my service period ends.
Exactly. And finally, you are clearly a traveler. Her service contract requires that she remain on Ilium.
I don't want them to take me off to a mine somewhere.
I'll talk to the Synthetic Insights rep and see what I can do.
Really? Thank you. I'd appreciate that.
So then he says, oh, it's okay. Our amino acids are all different. So it's not like we can get diseases or anything if we go natural.
I'm telling you, this is why you shouldn't date humans.
So then I had to explain about cross-species fluid contact. Completely killed the mood.
Not to mention that you're a Quarian. How could he be so insensitive?
Can I help you with something?
How'd you like to get your hands on an expert Quarian AI programmer?
If you'd like to submit a resume, I... Wait. Is this that slave? Synthetic Insights has no interest in purchasing slave labor. We're under enough scrutiny from the Citadel without engaging in practices the Council disapproves of. To be frank, we're hardly hiring anyone. The Geth attack on the Citadel didn't engender much love for artificial intelligence.
It sounds like Synthetic Insights is worried about its reputation. Hiring this Quarian would help.
Buying a slave helps our reputation. How exactly do you figure?
Purchase the contract, minus the fee for early emancipation, then free the Quarian and garnish wages for reimbursement.
Interesting. We look good for hiring a Quarian, and we can say that we freed slaves out of the goodness of our hearts. All right, I'll run up a contract. The board might wet its pants, but we could use the good publicity. This Quarian had better be good, though.
Synthetic Insights just sent over the contract. I cannot thank you enough.
I'm happy to help.
Here, for your trouble. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll get this service contract transferred.
Thank you. I'll stay out of trouble this time.
These poor Quarians on their pilgrimages.
I still don't see why we're here. Salarians do not get married. My family simply negotiated a reproduction contract.
Whatever. It's the closest you guys get to a wedding. And that means you get a bachelor party. End of story.
I don't understand. Humans celebrate wedding contracts by tempting infidelity? That makes no sense.
Calm down, man. Don't embarrass me in front of the stripper.
What do Turians do? Do Turians do this too?
I'm just here for the drinks.
You said that bachelor parties are for very close friends. We're just co-workers.
We've been co-workers for 5 years, though. Aren't Solarian years like dog years?
Okay, now that's offensive. I appreciate the gesture, but my people don't even have sex drives the way humans do.
Uh-huh. Take a look at that, man. Everybody likes the Asari. Everybody.
But we actually reproduce by... My word. She is very limber. I can appreciate her dancing in an aesthetic manner, but I don't have feelings of... She is a lovely shade of blue.
Okay. That makes my legs hurt just watching it. And my knees are meant to bend that way.
Welcome to Eternity. I'm Athena Asari Matriarch and Bartender. What can I get you?
I love this Asari. She's my second favorite.
Hello. Spoiler alert, Liara's daddy.
You're an Asari Matriarch? I thought Matriarchs served as honored advisors.
Right. Which I do here at this bar. I know. Not what you'd expect. But nobody on Thessia wanted to listen to my wise counsel, so here I am. Dad was a Krogan who fought in the Rachni Wars. My mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions. I've pretty much seen it all.
Your mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions?
I don't know whether she fought. She scouted, sniped a few people, and blew up a couple of space stations. You know, commando stuff. She'd put the old commando leathers on for special nights with Dad. Goddess, that was embarrassing.
You said your father fought in the Rachni Wars?
Yeah, when he was young. Loved showing off his war scars. Krogan think they're sexy. Me, I go for asses. I was a girl, he'd tell me about landing on this poison-filled world and stomping a Rachni queen into muck. Scientists say all that stuff about us getting genetic material from the father is crap. Seems like I got a bit of his mouth, though.
If your mother fought in the rebellions and your father was a Krogan, Didn't that cause tension?
They didn't meet until a few hundred years after the Turians put the boot in with the damn genophage. As far as either one knew, they were both just warriors. Dad boasted. Mom stayed quiet. Mom was a matriarch herself. Dad was near on 1,000 when the truth came out.
What happened when he found out?
I was about 100, shaking my ass in some sleazy bar. They got me on the link. Told me that they were gonna have it out. And made me promise to love whichever one survived. Turned out to be damn easy, since neither one did. Family, huh? What a kick in the quad.
What's it like living for nearly 1,000 years?
Violent. Wars break out. Colonies get destroyed. Mindwar. Eden Prime. Pharos. It's been like that forever. You find peace in whatever arms will hold you. Turian, Elcor, Hanar. Even had a pureblood daughter. I was the father. Didn't work out. And one day you wake up, your figure's gotten matriarchal, and everyone else is too young to remember how the Quarians looked inside those suits.
Hang on a second. I gotta do something. Alright, apologies for that.
Why is a matriarch in a bar serving drinks?
It's better than what most other matriarchs are doing. Look at that screw-up with Saren and his Geth a few years back. All that Asari wisdom got the Destiny Ascension blown to hell, and now you humans are in charge. And I warned him. Told people on Thessia what was coming, and they didn't want to hear it.
What didn't they want to hear?
That art and philosophy and political prowess wasn't gonna cut it. We can't go a single Asari lifetime without some big war breaking out. We need to get our daughters working earlier, not spending their wild maiden years stripping or in merc bands. When I started talking about making new mass relays ourselves, they laughed and blew up my ass. So now, I serve drinks.
Thanks for telling me about that.
That's what I'm here for, babe. Get you anything else?
I'd like something to drink.
Sure. I'll set up a tab at the drink kiosk. Knock yourself out. Literally, if you want. Just don't drink anything for Turians or Quarians. Does nasty things to your insides. Once saw Krogan drink a liquefied Turian on a dare 6 or 7 centuries back. Nobody came out of that one looking pretty.
Thanks for setting up the drinks.
Right. Don't eat the nuts in the Red Bulls. They're for Turians and Quarians. You'll get cramps.
Oh shit, I worded that wrong. Hang on a second. Go ahead, Jay.
at least I didn't disappear through the counter this time. Oh, whoa, everything's wobbly. What did I drink? A mystery drink? Let's have some wine. Oh, hang on a second. There's something I actually needed to do.
Welcome back, babe. Can I get you anything? Sorry, no sex. Just cleaned the bar.
Just looking around.
Pleasure as always.
Yeah, sorry to text you in the middle of what you may have been doing, Jay. I just kind of like... I don't feel comfortable...
You deserve somebody
saying that and everything, unless you don't mind me saying so.
Oh, I think I'm just going to stop dating for a while.
No, don't do that. Don't let some human spoil you.
It's always the same thing.
Ooh, she could get sick. She's vulnerable. I wonder what she looks like under the helmet.
You'll find someone out there who cares about you for who you are.
Over here.
Has noted a correlation between intelligence.
If this is the best you have, I'll make do. But you're certain the neural stimulators.
Yes, Dark Shadow, it's because you're literally getting mind fucked.
Listen, I know the data is vital to the Kurosa family. Asana Dantius didn't give us time to pack. I'm lucky I got out at all. Her mercenaries were starting to shoot. If she lets us back in, I'll get it, I promise. If not, well, we'll just have to hope. Excuse me, I'm on an important call.
A cock-a-doodle door? Is that what you're calling it?
Serena?
Who wants to know?
Name's Shepard. Liara Tassoni said you might have information on Thane Krios.
Tana, cover for me.
That Asari just over like here. Lifted her head like, what?
Yeah, I know who Thane Krios is. I might have passed him some information, but I didn't hire him. What do you want to know?
Maybe you could help me find him.
I can tell you, but you won't stop him. When he contacted me, I checked up on him. The man never gives up on a job. I ran security for Nasana Dantius. Then I found out she was having people killed to cover up her dirty secrets. She fired me when I confronted her. Her loss. I might have been good enough to stop Thane from taking her down.
Animated Plus is a dude. And his name is Jay. If you actually watch the first episode of the Lewd Lounge, he was in it.
If you work there, you must have an idea what his opposition will be.
Eclipse mercs, high-tech killer, undisciplined but very well-equipped. They don't much care who they kill, as long as they're paid for it. Thane has quite a reception waiting for him. I told him all I knew. He didn't seem worried.
Who is she?
A wealthy speculator with a nasty disposition. She's killed her business rivals, government officials. I heard she even took out her own sister. If anyone deserves killing, she does.
Just tell me where I can find Thane.
The Dantius Towers. Penthouse level of Tower 1. There's a second tower still under construction.
Yeah, but when we say cock-a-doodle-doo, a rooster, a cock.
It doesn't sound like Nisana's just gonna let me in.
She's as smart as she is paranoid. No one's getting in or out of there without a fight. I can get you in, but you'll only get one shot. You'd better be ready.
You're just offering your help. No strings attached?
You're going to look for Thane. Nisana's mercenaries will try to stop you. At the least, you'll distract her guards. Take a little fire, give Thane a clear shot. I didn't hire him to kill Nisana, but I won't shed any tears when she gets what's coming to her.
Chat got a little disturbing. Just dead.
Do you know anything else about Thane?
Not much. He did say that he's not doing the hit for money. Nobody hired him. I wanted to know who I was helping, and he said he's doing this job on his own. That he had to restore the balance of his life. I don't know. Maybe he's crazy. If he takes down Nisana, I don't care why he does it.
Let's go then.
Good. I'm tired of this crap. We'll go tonight, as soon as the shift workers clear out of Tower 2.
Well, you enjoy your Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Magnificent game, you're gonna have nightmares then.
Are heavily guarded, and you'll find more resistance closer to the penthouse. So, this assassin, you planning to stop him?
I'm just here to make sure he survives.
There they are, the Dantius Towers. You'll have to get up to the second tower and cross the bridge to the penthouse. Her mercs will fight you every step, but it's your best chance.
Why don't we just save time and take the shuttle up?
She's got mercs with rockets just waiting for you to try. You get maybe halfway up before they shot you down. Besides, your assassin won't go in that way. Best to go in low.
All right, let's do this.
Hold on. They'll be here to greet you soon enough. Good luck, Shepard.
That shot of her reaching for the car door and looking up at the building actually reminded me of a shot in the first RoboCop. I need that. No, actually, I'm dealing with... Eh, fuck it, I'll figure it out. Jay, Billy, I think you guys have met your match with each other. I just need Bilbo in here and then fuck, it's a party.
Help.
He's still alive.
I can't feel my legs. My chest is killing me.
Who did this to you? And why?
We're just night workers. Nasana sent them after us. She sent the mechs to round us up, but we didn't hear. They just started shooting.
They just attacked you?
Yes. They were too slow. It was horrible. Everyone screaming. The mechs said there was no time. Nasana wanted us out of the way immediately. Then the dogs...
He's not going to make it if we don't help him.
Here. That should ease the pain and keep you alive until help arrives.
Thank you. That helps.
Take your time.
I think I'm better. Find the other workers. Help them.
Any idea how many mercs Nasana's got?
A lot. Dozens of them are wandering around here all day. You'll find more the further you go.
My Shep is not blonde and blue-eyed. She's not modeled after Samus.
I need to get up to the penthouse. Any suggestions?
Take the service elevator to the upper floors. The bridge between the towers isn't finished, but if you're careful, watch out for the mercs. They're everywhere.
Why would Nasana kill her own workers?
To her, we're expendable. But I didn't realize she was that ruthless. My friends, co-workers, slaughtered. They were jumping off ledges to escape the dogs.
I'll do what I can.
Thank you.
Let's get moving.
Taking cover!
That was a weird-ass recoil.
Going dark.
I need ammo. Because I am a sniper whore. Oh shit. Oh shit, Garrus went down. What the fuck, Garrus? Oh my god, that was fucking weird. Damn it, I don't have ammo in that one.
Poking.
Really? God damn it, Garrus. I am not wasting fucking metagel bullshit on you. Fucking dick. Come over here. I'm gonna fucking punch you instead. Yep, I sure will.
Grab cover!
Oh, hello. That was close. I'm gonna die of stupidness. Do the funny again, yeah. Whoa, where the fuck am I? Oh, okay. Yeah, let's try that shit again. Oh, then you should have been here for the last stream. I think you were for a little bit. I was fucking up royally. Actually... Does work on them. Sometimes there is something in there. I never had this much of an ammo problem. This is fucking weird.
Well, I don't know how Art plays, because I do have a Unreal Tournament, but he's not on my friends list. Okay, let's see if there's anything down here first. Besides me running out of breath constantly. God damn, I really need to sneeze. Ouch. That sneeze hurt my abs. They're sore. And that was a good eye rub. Oh, good God. All right, let's try this again.
Santa's not paying you to stand around.
Fine. But I...
Hello. The first couple times I play this, I never actually noticed that. But it's like, how did it get past the fan? Is what I want to know. How the fuck did I miss?
Give me a target!
Aw, man. Oh my god, I'm totally sucking right now.
Coming.
Lead the way.
You got it.
Come on, Kasumi. Really? Get against the fucking... What the hell? What?
Fuck you.
I'm like shooting right above his fucking gun. Okay, there was actually- wait, there was something- there was something back there, hang on. Is it this?
Focus.
Yeah, okay, that was that door. Okay. What would I be nervous about, except for the fact that I'm trying not to get all ragey? Ooh, what's down here? Yes. A sniper rifle. Give me that bitch.
Please, don't kill us. We'll go. We'll go. Hey, look. They're not Eclipse. You're here to help us, right?
It's one reason I'm here. Come on out. It's safe enough.
Thank you. We are in your debt.
Maybe you can help me. I'm looking for someone. Not a merc. He's on his own.
Well, whoever sealed us in here. When he found us, I thought we were dead. But he just closed the door and locked us in.
Locked you in? Sounds like our assassin was trying to keep them safe.
Assassin?
Here for Nasana, I bet. She's got it coming. You treat people like this, it always comes back to bite you in the ass.
I need to get to Nasana's penthouse. What's the quickest way?
Cargo elevator is the only way up right now.
They're still working up top. Watch your step. Some of the walls aren't in, and it's a long way down.
Cold, too. I hate working up there.
Nasana's not exactly your favorite person?
She's a hard woman to work for.
That's an understatement. She works us long hours, no overtime, and this is what you get in payment.
She's unpleasant, to say the least.
Why not just quit?
We would if we could.
What's stopping you?
Our contract. We're stuck until the job's done. Quitting for any reason can be hazardous to your health.
We hear that anyone who leaves early tends to disappear. Probably just a rumor.
But who wants to find out for sure?
Did you see the one who locked you in? Do you know where he might have gone?
He's no Salarian, I can tell you that. But I've no idea where he went. Sorry.
If he's after Nasana, he'll be heading to the upper levels.
How many workers were in the tower? Are there many more of you?
Not alive. We were lucky.
Well, some got out before the dogs were sent in. Maybe a few are hiding somewhere.
I wouldn't stay here too long. It should be safe down on the lower floors.
I was just thinking the same thing. Let's go, everybody!
Seriously, that Salarian reminds me of a character from South Park.
Tell your assassin to aim for her head. Because she doesn't have a heart.
Get moving!
They're cooking.
We're a little exposed out here, especially if anyone's in that elevator.
I was just thinking the same thing myself, Garrus.
Well, there's no lack of cover.
Moving to cover.
I'm going!
Yeah, move your fucking ass, you idiot.
You got it.
Well, he dead. I fucking hate dealing with Krogans. Time.
Turn around very slowly.
Damn it.
Have you seen the assassin?
Why are you looking for him? You're not one of Nasana's mercs. Who are you?
You got two ways down, express or coach. Your choice.
Look, pal. Even if I knew where he was, I wouldn't tell you.
Not the answer I was looking for.
I've got nothing more to say to you. If you shoot me, my team...
All right, take care, Billy.
Goodbye.
Harsh, but I guess he had it coming.
Punch through their arm. No. One less to worry about.
Suck at this. Okay, I guess there's nothing else.
Are you guys all right in here?
Get back! Get back! I'll shoot!
Relax. Don't do anything you'll regret.
I don't want to hurt you, but I will. I said get back! I'll do it! Please, don't make me do it.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. What's your name?
I'm Talon. Don't come any closer.
Talon, I'm Commander Shepard. I don't work with the Mercs, and I don't want to hurt you. I'm here to help.
All right. Here. Don't feel so...
Talon! He's my brother. I just want to see if he's all right. Are you the ones who shot the Merc?
It wasn't me. Your brother didn't do it?
No. Talon was standing here with me.
What happened exactly?
The Merc found us and shouted at us to move. We panicked, and he shouted more. I thought he was going to kill us, then his head just exploded. Talon picked up the Merc's gun, but we were too afraid to leave. Then you showed up.
A perfect headshot, with no collateral damage. Very impressive.
How safe is that bridge out there?
The bridge is stable, but the wind's your real problem. If it doesn't throw you off, the Mercs will definitely try. There's a lot of them out there.
I'm looking for someone. Probably the guy who killed this Merc.
Talon thought he saw someone following us, but he's been a bit on edge. I haven't seen anyone but the Mercs.
Is the bridge the only way to the penthouse in the other tower?
From here, yeah. It won't be easy. Mercs are patrolling the other side. Whatever Nasana's hiding from must be pretty scary.
There are still Mercs up here. You should get to the lower levels.
No need to convince me. Talon, come on, get up.
Can we go home now?
Yeah, we're getting out of here. Thank you.
I'm afraid your men aren't able to respond, Nasana.
Damn it!
Affirmative.
Wrong button.
On my way.
Understood.
Garrus, fucking move.
Your toes! You're off my screen!
Explosives! He's already past us! He's already passed! Look out! They're behind him!
Requesting assistance.
This should come in handy.
been spotted.
I don't care what you do. No one gets across that bridge.
Red force casualty. Bring him down.
Moving to cover.
Right in the fucking dick. What's up, Bear? You gonna actually stick around, or are you gonna just go fuck off and go somewhere else? Really? Oh, I guess he disappeared.
Going silent. There. Get them off me.
Now, wait. Before you kill me, just tell me who hired you.
Who do you think it was?
Screw you.
Charming.
Kill me then. I'm not playing your stupid games. Well, you made it this far. Now what?
You really think I'm here to kill you?
Do you have another reason for destroying my tower? Decimating my security?
I'm just looking for someone.
You expect me to believe that? Is it credits? Is that what you want? Just tell me your price. We can make this problem go away.
All the credits in the world won't make this problem go away, Nisana.
Who the hell gave you the right to play God? I may not be perfect, but look at you. We both kill people for money. What's the difference?
You kill people because you think they're beneath you. They're in your way. I kill people because they leave me no choice.
You've got a choice. You don't have to do this. I can tell you.
What?
I heard something. Damn it. Check the other entrances. You stay put. When I'm finished dealing with this nuisance, you and I are going to... Who...
Impressive. You certainly know how to make an entrance.
I was hoping to talk to you.
I apologize, but prayers for the wicked must not be forsaken.
She certainly was wicked.
Not for her, for me. The measure of an individual can be difficult to discern by actions alone. Take you, for instance. All this destruction, chaos. I was curious to see how far you'd go to find me. Well, here I am.
How'd you know I was coming at all?
I didn't. Not until you marched in the front door and started shooting. Nisana had become paranoid. You saw the strength of her guard force. She believed one of her sisters would kill her. You were a valuable distraction.
You used me so you could kill her.
I needed a diversion. You needed to speak with me. You certainly fulfilled your end of the bargain. What would you like to discuss?
Someone's been abducting entire human colonies. We're gonna stop them. We already know the culprits. A race called the Collectors.
I've heard of them. Attacking the Collectors would require passing through the Omega-4 relay. No ship has ever returned from doing so.
They told me it was impossible to get to Ilos, too.
A fair point. You built a career on performing the impossible. This was to be my last job. I'm dying. Low survival odds don't concern me. The abduction of your colonists does.
You're dying? Are you contagious? How long do you have?
If you're interested, we can discuss it on your ship. The problem isn't contagious, and it won't affect my work.
I hadn't heard that. Is there anything I can do?
Giving me this opportunity is enough. The universe is a dark place. I'm trying to make it brighter before I die. Many innocents died today. I wasn't fast enough and they suffered. I must atone for that. I will work for you, Shepard. No charge.
Okay. So now I got my sexy assassin, and now, do I really want to go after Samara, or should I save that? I don't even know how long I've been streaming for. An hour and a half? I think that's good enough.
I've heard impressive stories, Krios. Sounds like you'll be an asset to the team. That is, if you're comfortable having an assassin watch your back.
I've accepted a contract. My arm is Shepard's.
Uh-huh. Don't know about you, but I'm loyal to more than my next paycheck.
Obviously he is, too. He's doing this mission gratis. What's your concern?
I don't like mercenaries. An assassin is just a precise mercenary.
An assassin is a weapon. A weapon doesn't choose to kill. The one who wields it does. Where shall I put my things? I'd prefer someplace dry, if anything is available.
The area near the life support plant on the crew deck tends to be slightly more arid than the rest of the ship.
Ah, an AI. My thanks.
He seems quite civil.
We need all the help we can get. He's not what I expected in an assassin. He may surprise you.
Yeah. And he may not.
Jacob, get the dick out of your ass. Fucking asshole. They really could have written him better. He's almost just as bad as Ashley.
What's this area of the ship?
This is the FTL communications room. In addition to interfacing with the FTL comm network, Normandy is fitted with a quantum entanglement communicator linked to the elusive man's office. This allows lag-free communication even when you operate off the comm grid.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
Yay. Nope, not talking to you. You're an asshole.
Commander, Jack's tattoos are beautiful. As colorful as her past, I'm sure. I have concerns with her temper, though.
You have worries about Jack?
I know she'll be solid under fire, but her attitude suggests deep personal issues. She pushes people away, yet approaches sex casually. I don't think she understands her own motivations. Just be careful when talking about personal matters.
I'll do my best not to piss her off.
Please warn me if you fail. I want a chance to hide. Anyway, what's up?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Jack would like to see you down in her hidey hole on the engineering deck. Anything else, Commander?
I actually haven't spoken to Jack since I got her in my crew. Actually, I want to go talk to Thane.
Do you need something?
Have a few minutes to talk?
Certainly. We haven't had a chance since I joined.
When we met you, you said you were dying.
Yes. I thought you'd want to know more. You don't have to worry about the rest of the crew. My illness is not communicable, even to other Drell. It's called Kepril syndrome.
What exactly is the problem?
My people are native to an arid world. Most of us now live on Kaje, the Hanar homeworld. It's very humid and rains every day. Our lungs can't deal with the moisture. Over time, the tissue loses its ability to absorb oxygen. It becomes harder to breathe. Eventually, we suffocate.
Can't they do something about that?
The Hanar have funded a genetic engineering program. They should be able to adapt us. The project has only been running for a few years. I don't believe my body will still draw breath by the time it bears fruit.
Then don't live on Kaje, or use breathers.
Drell have a close relationship with the Hanar. We rely on each other. The best we can do is keep our homes very dry inside.
Are you gonna be all right till the end of the mission?
I should be fine for another 8 to 12 months. The more time I spend in humid environments, the faster it progresses. I think it's safe to say that by the time my body is incapacitated, we'll be victorious. Or dead. Either way, I won't be a burden to you.
Is there anything we can do here? Normandy has a state-of-the-art medical bay.
No, thank you. It's being attended to. If the finest medical minds in the Hanar illuminated primacy can't solve the problem, I doubt your ship's medic could. Thank you for your concern. Trust me, this won't affect my performance. Do you need something?
Have a few minutes to talk?
Later. I'd like to consider what we've already discussed.
Okay. I should go.
I shall return to my meditations.
I totally did not want to go in there.
Ugh. Thank you, Commander. Rupert put the new supplies to good use. Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Can it wait for a bit? I'm in the middle of some calibrations.
Talk to you later, Garrus.
Fuck me. I'll be here if you need. Fucking hates that line so much. Oh, that's a wall. All right, let's go talk to Jack.
Tight little group you got here, and a pretty nice ship. You'd be rich if you took to piracy, but you wouldn't. I can't figure you, Shepard. Doesn't matter. I've got to talk to you about something.
I'd like to ask you a few things.
Later. I have to talk to you now. I got thoughts like little bugs crawling in and out of my head. I can't stop them. You know I have a history with Cerberus. You know how far back it goes?
I'll listen to anything you have to say, Jack.
Your pal, the elusive man? Never seen him before, but Cerberus raised me. First thing I remember is my cell door in a Cerberus base. They did experiments, drugged me, tortured me. Whatever chance I had to be normal, they stole it by trying to turn me into some superbiotic. The doctors, the other kids, every one of them hated me. They let me suffer.
What did they hope to gain by torturing a little girl?
It was something about pain breaking down mental barriers and how it might clear the way for a more biotic power. I'm sure there was a payoff due at some point, but I wasn't gonna see it. I was wired up in a cell.
They tortured you just to see if they could make a strong biotic? That's it?
Wasn't in a position to ask, Shepard. All I know is a little girl crying in a cell, begging for the pain to stop.
You love the power they gave you.
They never gave me a choice.
How did you get out of there?
There was some kind of emergency, and I made a break for it. The other kids came out of their cells and attacked me. So did the guards. I just killed everything in my way and ran. Guess my biotics had developed faster than they thought. I managed to get a shuttle off the ground. Drifted until a freighter picked me up. The crew used me, then sold me. That's my uplifting escape story.
There were other children in the base?
I didn't know much about them. I was kept separate. They hated me just like everyone else there. When I broke out, I had to fight through them all. I showed them, but there's a loose end I need to deal with.
You're absolutely certain that Cerberus was running the facility?
I was a kid, but I wasn't dumb. I know how to listen. It was Cerberus. Don't care how far down the chain it was. They thought they were so clever. Turns out, mess with someone's head enough, and you can turn a scared kid into an all-powerful bitch. Fucking idiots.
I'm going to talk to the elusive man, and he'd better have some answers.
He'll just deny everything. That's not what I'm after anyway. I found the coordinates in your files. I want to go to the Telton facility on Pravia, where they tortured and drugged me. I want to go to the center of the place, myself. I want to deploy a big fucking bomb, and I want to watch from orbit when it goes.
I'll set a course for Pragya.
I owe you, Shepard.
Okie dokie.
I hear that Rupert is actually cooking some good meals lately.
Yeah, right. That scunner couldn't serve a... Hinted on it.
Too slick ass, anyway.
Aye, the right hand.
Shepard?
Just checking in, making sure you're acclimatizing.
The hold is too open, not enough cover. Armor is limited. Warlord Granth would target here to scatter heavy cargo, then focus on engines. That's what tank imprints show about human ships, anyway. It's how I learned from the tank. Old pictures where memory is. Like holding a book for a child. Just remember this, picture after picture. No help with finding a reason to care.
What other human info is floating around in there?
Less than a finger deep to sever your spine. You're soft. Salarians, Asari, all soft. Quarians, not so much. Turians, you have to work the blade, I guess. Don't see much point to it, though. Much point. Never mind.
Something must move you. You're as genetically Krogan as you can get.
I see suffering, the dead, and I think weak. I'm supposed to be strong. My guts were grown from thousands more worthy. The dead were weak. If they were strong, I wouldn't be needed. I don't know why Okir started teaching. When he turned on the tank the first time, I screamed. Weak, pitiful.
So you started small, but you became what you are. Not everyone gets that chance.
I'm built for strength, but didn't earn it. I just am. Those dead were strong enough to try, even if they lost. The perfect Krogan, ignoring what made me. No strength in that. I'll take another look at what happened to the Krogan. Find a reason to care about it.
Poor Grunt. I don't feel like talking to Zaid. Okay, so I'm going to that's not the save button. I'm going to save my ass right here. And we'll go after Samara next. But for those who did pop in and everything, thank you for keeping me company. Billy Magnificent Gaming. Bear for just popping in randomly. Jay Daichi. And also Digital Man. And Billy. Thank you, Billy and Jay, for keeping me entertained with your random nonsense in the chat, too. That shit was kind of funny. But, yeah. It is rather late, and it's only 11:30, but everyone else is probably sleeping. Anyway, take care.